Hi, my name is Becky Jennings, and this is the Responsible Parenting Podcast. I give you the transformational tools to stop reacting to your children in the moment and start responding with intention.
When dealing with frustrating behavior, yelling can quickly become our default way of handling things. But since you're listening to this podcast, I know you're looking for a better way. That's why I created my free guide to help you get out of the yelling cycle. This six-part free guide gives you the foundational information to start breaking the toxic yelling cycle. Click the link in my show notes to get your free guide today. This might be the hardest cycle to break as parents, but I have your back, and together we can change the way we respond.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Responsible Parenting. I'm your host, Becky Jennings. Today, I'm really excited because when I was going back through episode 37 and I was editing it, it's the interview between Sari and Sasha, which if you haven't listened to it, please go back. It is so inspiring. I interviewed a mom and a 15-year-old son, and we talked about basically growing up in this responsive style and what it looks like. And he respects his parents so much. And we talked about the difference between what his relationship with his parents looks like and what his friends' relationships with their parents look like, and the difference in parenting styles. And he talked about a massive thing for him that really allowed him to just default into respecting his parents so much. And that was understanding. The fact that his parents had a desire to understand, they sought to understand, and they really spent a good amount of time working with him, listening, seeing him, validating, seeking that understanding of what was going on internally for him. What were the circumstances around him to choose the behavior that he chose, to respond the way he responded? They didn't come at him with him being the villain or accusing or a judgment or a preconceived notion of who he was and that's why he did what he did. They really sought to understand. They were sympathetic of his circumstances. They became very aware of him. And from that place of seeking to understand, he felt a deep amount of respect shown to him. And for him, that allowed him to then try to understand his parents, to try to understand the situation around him. And so it made me think that it's kind of this interesting workaround to respect. It's almost as if the system of respect has been set up that a child automatically has to respect the parent, right? It's almost like that's the assumption. You respect a parent because they brought you into this world. They provide for you. They give you all of this stuff. They support you. They do all of these things for you. They basically keep you alive, right? A child should automatically respect the parent. But does a parent automatically respect the child? Not necessarily. You know, we grew up in an environment, in a system of parenting, this traditional normative way of parenting where a child should be seen and not heard, where a child should perform these really truncated behaviors around adults and authority so that they can show respect, so they can be respectful. But as the adult, it is our job to teach respect. And we teach respect by giving respect. Our children do not understand this large concept of respect unless they see it modeled to them. And what I heard from Sasha is that one of the biggest parts of modeling mutual respect was seeking to understand, was taking the time to listen, was taking the time to strip off the labels and the lenses and see Sasha for who he was and to try to gain more context, understanding, try to get into the nuances of his personhood. And from that place, it is so much easier to drop the judgments. It is so much easier to show up with compassion, to show up with empathy, to show up with just a deeper desire to know the person. So it just made me really think, like, is understanding or seeking to understand. The act of asking questions, getting curious, is that how we teach respect in a really beautiful way? As opposed to jamming lessons down our children's throats of how they should act, what they need to do, this performance that we expect of them. What if instead, if we really, really, really want our children to show up with more respect, if we want our children to talk to us better, if we want our children to do things better, if we want our children to show us respect, then let's teach them that by getting curious about their lives. Let's teach them that by dropping the labels and judgments of them and asking questions, of being sympathetic and aware of what's going on for them. Let's really zoom out as opposed to looking at each micro moment as an assault or as a challenge in behavior that we need to undo or as something that they did wrong in this bad, bad, bad behavior that we need to shame our way out of or suppress it enough that it stops showing up. Let's get curious. Let's forgive. Let's increase this window of tolerance of actual behavior that is totally normal. And let's stop looking at the behavior as the definition of our child. Let's stop looking at the behavior as the identity of our child. Let's go beneath the behavior, get super hyper curious about what drove the behavior. Because when we do that, it's actually chipping away at our own judgments of our own resentments. It's creating a larger pause for us between the moment, the stimulus, the period of time where we could be really hyperreactive. It's creating a larger gap between that and our response. And the gap, if we are having a really hard time pausing, breathing, slowing down, right, using those tools, then if we can hold on to one tool saying, during this period of time, before I choose the words I'm going to say in response to the action, right? Whether it's the correction, the punishment, the consequence, that whatever that we normally say really quickly. What if we expand that out and give ourselves a pause just by asking curiosity questions? I'm wondering what was going on for you in that moment. I'm sure that must have felt like scary, exciting, different. That might have felt new for you. I'm curious as to how that felt. I'm curious as to what you were thinking in that moment. Were you nervous about your friends not accepting you? Were you fearful that if you didn't go along with it, you'd be pushed out to the side? Did you not want to be left alone? You know, let's get really curious about this, because when we start to ask those questions, we start to begin the process of seeing underneath the behavior. And we start to see what that need was that wasn't being met. What that need, that primal need within our child, what was going on for them. Then we can start to address the situation and teach the skill around it, because now we know the root of it, not the symptom that we saw presenting in the behavior. Then we start to see the root. We actually start to see what drove the behavior. We start to see where that behavior spawned from. Because all of our behaviors are our best attempt with the tools and the skills that we have to meet the need in that moment. So by seeking to understand, we're doing two things in this moment. We are not only deciphering what that root cause was, what was underneath the behavior, the unmet need, but we are also unknowingly and in a much deeper way, we are teaching our children how to show up with respect. We are teaching our children how to view situations around them. We are teaching our children how to be in tune with what's going on in their body. We are teaching our children how to be spoken to. We are teaching not only respectful of themselves, but we're teaching them how to be respectful of others. So if respect is a huge thing for you, instead of jamming the lesson of respect down their throats and saying, you have to talk to me this way, talk to them in the way that you want to be spoken to. Seek to understand, because when you are yelling at your child to ask or demanding respect, what you are doing is you are saying, I have an unmet need. I wish you would understand that. So understanding is deeply correlated with respect. And it's fascinating when we break all of this down, and it's so human. We all want to be understood. And when we are understood, we actually feel respected. Isn't that interesting? So I want to thank Sasha, a 15-year-old kid who broke this down so beautifully. If we seek to understand and we get really curious about the other person's world, we respect them. We show them respect, and they are going to feel respected and in turn show respect back. So I hope that was insightful and interesting to you. I love these concepts and how we can just boil it all down to these unmet needs that we all have within us, and how if we get curious and if we stop labeling and judging and vilifying each other's behaviors, really all it is these unmet needs that are screaming out. And most of the time they're screaming out in defense because they feel like they have to protect themselves. So let's seek to understand before we say anything next to our children. All right. Have a great rest of your week, and I will see you next time.
Thank you for listening to the Response Able Parenting Podcast. If you like what you heard, please take a moment to rate, review, and subscribe. If you know someone who would benefit from this podcast, I'd be honored if you'd share this episode with them. Until next time, know that you are enough, you are capable, you've made it through all of your hardest days, and we will keep growing on this parenting journey together. This podcast was produced by Kim Kelty and myself, Becky Jennings, and edited by The Kelty Method, Branding and Podcasting.